Title: Painted Wall Geology, Great Canyon Wall.
Although we have a great view of the wall here, one more interesting geologic phenomenon at this overlook is at the river. Look for the sandbars and loose slopes below the painted wall.
Rocky talus.
Does this debris look like it's in a natural place for a river canyon whose floodwaters can be as strong as 19,000 cubic feet per second? Certainly not.
Foamy rapids.
Floods with that magnitude would scour the canyon floor and flush all rocks and plant debris downstream. So why do sandbars exist down at the river? This is because a series of dams have been placed along the river to divert water to surrounding communities and provide flood control. Nowadays, the river flows regularly around 1,000 cubic feet per second, with high waters rarely reaching more than 5,000 cubic feet per second.
Water cascading over dams.
What other impacts have these flow controls done to the river? The river, as a downcutting tool and large rock transporter, has changed dramatically.
Water on rock.
Every river can carry a specific sediment load, the amount of solid material it can transport, such as silt, sand, and larger rocks. The higher the flow of the river, the larger the rocks and boulders it can carry. Imagine the erosive force a large boulder would have floating and crashing its way down the river.
Rushing rapids.
High water flows have a lot to do with how the canyon is formed, not only by the water carving the canyon, but also by the sediment load crashing and wearing away at the surrounding rocks.
River with large boulders.
Now that the Gunnison River is no longer allowed to have these high flows, how will this affect the canyon's future? How will the shape of the canyon change 100, 1,000, even 1,000,000 years from now?
Aerial view of the canyon showing the winding rim road.